Good morning and welcome to St. Ambrose. In a special way, we welcome those of you who are new to our parish or visiting. You are very welcome here. Our opening song is number 450, Amazing Grace, 450.
Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Last week, I think it was last week, we heard the disciples in the boat ask one another, "Who can this be whom even the winds and the sea obey?" In today's gospel, Jesus following that trip does something impossible except for the one who is God's Son. Let us present ourselves humbly before the Lord, so that our own smallness may be taken up by his greatness and our sinfulness be forgiven by his mercy.
Lord Jesus, you raise the dead to life in the spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Yeah.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. God did not make death, nor does he rejoice in the destruction of the living. For he fashioned all things that they might have being, and the creatures of the world are wholesome, and there is not a destructive drug among them, nor any domain of the netherworld on earth, for justice is undying. For God formed man to be imperishable. The image of his own nature he made him. But by the envy of the devil, death entered the world. And they who belong to his company experience it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, as you excel in every respect, in faith, discourse, knowledge, all earnestness, and in the love we have for you, may you excel in this gracious act also. For you know the gracious act of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, for your sake he became poor, so that by his poverty you might become rich. Not that others should have relief while you are burdened, but that as a matter of equality, your abundance at the present time should supply their needs, so that their abundance may also supply your needs, that there may be equality. As it is written, whoever had much did not have more, and whoever had little did not have less. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
With you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus had crossed again in the boat to the other side, a large crowd gathered around him, and he stayed close to the sea. One of the synagogue officials, named Jairus, came forward. Seeing him, he fell at his feet and pleaded earnestly with him, saying, "My daughter is at the point of death. Please, come lay your hands on her, that she may get well and live." He went off with him, and a large crowd followed him and pressed upon him. There was a woman afflicted with hemorrhages for 12 years. She had suffered greatly at the hands of many doctors, and had spent all that she had, yet was not helped, but only grew worse. She had heard about Jesus and came up behind him in the crowd and touched his cloak. She said, "If I but touch his clothes, I shall be cured." Immediately, her flow of blood dried up. She felt in her body that she was healed of her affliction. Jesus, aware at once that power had gone out from him, turned around in the crowd and asked, "Who has touched my clothes?" But his disciples said to Jesus, "You see how the crowd is pressing upon you, and yet you ask, 'Who touched me?'" And he looked around to see who had done it. The woman, realizing what had happened to her, approached in fear and trembling. She fell down before Jesus and told him the whole truth. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has saved you. Go in peace and be cured of your affliction." While he was still speaking, people from the synagogue official's house arrived and said, "Your daughter has died. Why trouble the teacher any longer? Disregarding the message that was reported, Jesus said to the synagogue official, "Do not be afraid, just have faith." He did not allow anyone to accompany him inside except Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. When they arrived at the house, the synagogue official, he caught sight of a commotion, people weeping and wailing loudly. So he went in and said to them, "Why this commotion and weeping? The child is not dead, but asleep." And they ridiculed him. Then he put them all out. He took along the child's father and mother and those who were with him and entered the room where the child was. He took the child by the hand and said to her, "Talitha cum," which means, "Little girl, I say to you, arise." The girl, a child of 12, arose immediately and walked around. At that, they were utterly astounded. He gave strict orders that no one should know this and said that she should be given something to eat. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
God is good
all the time.
And all the time.
God is true.
Who touched me? I would like to begin today's reflection with a little joke. We are told that there are these three people, a deaf man, a blind man, and a disabled man. They heard a rumor that God had come down to a church in the village to heal the sick. So they all went to find out if it was true. So when they were there, to the first man, the deaf man, God signed to him. So he did something like this. Who can interpret that? What can I do for you? Then the deaf man signed back to Jesus, to God, and said, "What does that mean? I would like you to heal me to hear." God touched the man and he was able to hear. Then he asked the blind man, the man number two, "What can I do for you?" He replied, "Lord, I want to see." God touched him and the blind man was able to see. Now the third man, who was disabled, was sitting on his wheelchair with his mouth wide open in amazement. So God looked at the man and asked him, "What can I do for you?" The man drew back and yelled, "Don't lay a finger on me. I am on disability." There are three ideals in life that all of us wish for. We want to be healthy, we want to be wealthy, and we want to be free of worry. And if we can have these three, health, wealth, and no worries, I think life would be very awesome. But happiness in life comes and goes. And that is because health and wealth come and go, and we worry about both. And the folly of life is this: we spend our health trying to gain wealth. And then we spend our wealth trying to regain our health. So regardless of our status in life, no one is exempt from worries of health and wealth. But above all these things, faith is very, very essential. Now, in today's gospel reading, we hear the good news of God's love and care for us, especially in our suffering. So the story presented to us by Mark is like a sandwich. We have a story within a story. Begins Jairus coming to Jesus, asking him to come and heal his daughter who was very sick. And off they went with a huge following, crowds around him. Now, along the way, this other story comes in. The woman who has been sick for 12 years, who has been suffering from hemorrhages for 12 years. And you know, at the time, such condition rendered one unclean. And therefore, she was not supposed to be close to anyone, not even supposed to be in that crowd or even to touch Jesus. But that is an obstacle right there. But she tells herself, if only I can touch the fringe of his cloak, I will be healed. That strong faith. So, and she dares to do that. It was not very easy to go through all these men around Jesus, but she managed to, and she touched Jesus. So that act of touching Jesus was actually supposed to make Jesus unclean. But with her faith, she was cured. And look what happens. Jesus stops and then asks, "Who touched me?" Then the disciples are telling Jesus, "Look, so many people around here. How do you ask who touched you with all this crowd pressing around?" Then Jesus takes time looking for the woman who touched him. Why does Jesus look for the woman who touched him? Jesus wants the woman not to go away thinking that she was cured by magic or just by touching the cloak of Jesus. Jesus wants the woman to know that it was not the cloth which healed her, but her faith. So she had overcome that obstacle. She was not supposed to be close to anyone, but her faith healed her. Now, when all this is happening, Jairus is not a happy man, because with this delay, Jesus being paying attention to this woman, that delay caused the daughter to die. So he wasn't very happy. And around that time, his servants arrive and say, "Don't bother the master. The daughter is dead. Why bother him?" That is another obstacle. But Jesus turns to Jairus and says, "Do not be afraid, have faith." Then the procession moves, and they arrive at the house, Jairus' house. And everybody's wailing and all the commotion. And Jesus asks, what is going on here? He's only asleep. Then they laugh at him and make fun of him. She's dead. So Jesus throws everybody else out, except James, Peter, and John, and the parents, and says to the young girl, Talitha kum, young girl, rise up. And she does, because of the faith. So the question we ought to ask ourselves, how faithful am I when I'm faced with obstacles in life, when these trials are just left, right, center? How faithful am I? So Jesus is inviting us to have that strong faith. From our first reading, the first reading also tells us that God created us in the image of his own nature. So we are created in God's love and created with God's love. So we are created in God's love and with God's love. So regardless of our status or personality or background, when we come before the Lord, in faith, with our needs, he will hear our prayer. So, in the sunshine of our confidence, let us give thanks to God with a grateful heart. In the darkness of our doubt, let us be humble and plead with the Lord. Whether we are like Jairus pleading with Jesus, or like the woman who came up from behind Jesus to touch his cloak, God knows our needs. So more than health or wealth, God wants us to have faith in him. So with faith in God, we know our prayer will be heard, and with faith, we wait for God to grant us our needs. So who touched me? If that touch of that woman, of the clock, just healed her with her faith, every time we come for Mass, even today, we not only touch Jesus, but we receive him. So just imagine, if only a touch has that great impact with faith, what about receiving Jesus into our lives? Even a greater impact on us and on our lives. So let us have that great faith and strengthen our faith always as we receive our Lord in the Eucharist. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let's stand together now. Let us pray our profession of faith. I believe
in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ,
the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For our sin and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified on the cross of the Father. He suffered, died, and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son and his worship of our God, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Let's bring our prayers now with confidence before the God who loves us so.
For the Church, may the Holy Spirit continue to animate her missionary work throughout the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who govern, may God bless them with prudence in their decision making. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and the suffering, may God mercifully grant them healing and strength. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For families in this faith community, may they always be open to the workings of the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died with faith in the Lord, may God grant them the reward he has promised his faithful servants. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our book of intentions and those calling and requesting prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sister diocese in Lodwar, Kenya, and our sister parish in Guatemala, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our St. Ambrose Parish family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Maria Zuniga, David Kramer, Carolyn Taranjo, Sam Bond, Lynn and Dolores Stedge, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Now let us invoke the intercession of our Blessed Mother as we say,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our song during the preparation of the gifts is number 472, There is a Balm in Gilead. 472.
Balm in Gilead to make the
God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right to give you thanks, truly just to give you glory, Father most holy, for you are the one God, living and true, existing before all ages and abiding for all eternity, dwelling in unapproachable light. Yet you, who alone are good, the source of life, have made all that is so that you might fill your creatures with blessings and bring joy to many of them by the glory of your light. And so in your presence are countless hosts of angels who serve you day and night, and gazing upon the glory of your face, glorify you without ceasing. With them too, we confess your name in exaltation, giving voice to every creature under heaven as we acclaim. Fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love. You formed man in your own image and entrusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when through disobedience he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death, for you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets you taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior. Made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, he shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose for us, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, if we now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, we remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, we may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory.
Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis, our Pope, Edward, our bishop, and the whole order of bishops and all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with all the apostles and saints in your kingdom. There, with the whole of creation, free from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we have confidence to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours now and forever.
O Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us not be together in the sign of Christ's peace.
Peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Our communion song is number 439, Be Not Afraid. 439.
Thank you to the 25 men and women who attended the training for extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion yesterday. This ministry is a great privilege and a most valuable service to offer to our parish community. to resume well the practice of receiving the precious blood of our Lord each Sunday. We want to have a good number of such ministers. If you missed this opportunity to prepare yourself for this service, please call the parish office. There will be another training session soon. Thank you for your support of the philanthropic works of the Pope and the administrative costs of the Vatican State through Peter Pence's collection this week. Your generosity is very much appreciated. Tucked in your St. Ambrose bulletin today is a brief series of sketches showing how the image of Mary will be presented in the Mary Prayer and Meditation Garden that's going to be built this summer. A poster is available for viewing in the vestibule as well. The St. Ambrose golf outing is fast approaching. Don't miss out. Please register your team soon. Call the parish office to register by phone or fill out the registration form that you will find in the vestibule. We hope to see you there. The parish office will be closed this coming week on Thursday, the 4th of July, in observance of Independence Day. We hope you have a wonderful and safe holiday. May God bless us all.
Let's stand and pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go forth, love, and serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
In honor of our 4th of July celebration this week, we will sing the first two verses of America the Beautiful, number 745. 745.